Everybody, welcome back to Terra Firma Craft Season 5, Episode 101 with me, Sid, and I'm starting to improve these. We've finally got these going, and I'm just waiting on the cross crops, but I've been busy. I say I've been busy. Realistically, these guys are the ones that have been busy. I have just been feeding gravel and everything from here, which is now completely empty, into there, and they've been doing their work, and the contents have gone into these two chests, which we'll check out in a moment. Just keep my eye on that as well. We've got quite a few crops ready to harvest, and I do need to seriously look at expanding these pens out and start these animals. If I don't do it soon now, then you know I'll never do it. Excellent, perfect, no weeds. I like it when we get no weeds. Right, so let's have a look. We should have a 414. Okay, pop, 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 and pop. That can go in there, that can go in there for now, that can go in there, that can keep growing. Let me show you the results of our sifting. So I sifted all of the gravel we had, all of the gabbro gravel, plus the sand, plus I did a basalt gravel run as well, just to try one, just to see what we got out of that. This is what we got out of one lot. So 6 diamonds, flint, quartz, certus quartz, agate, amethyst, beryl, emerald, garnet, jade, opal, jasper, gold, 3 of those, couple of cassiterite, some garnerite, 2 more stacks of kimberlite. Obviously, as you recall, that will grind down into diamonds. Doesn't have any other use other than that. Serpentine, we'll make serpentine powder, which allows us to make stuff. Rubies, sapphires, topaz, tourmaline, charged certus, mithril, lots of more kimberlite up there, more serpentine, more garnerite, more cassiterite, and then when we go up to the top one, yet more still, and garnerite again, serpentine, this is from the basalt gravel, and then that was from the sand. The sand, really not worth it. You got a little bit of stuff, but yeah, a bit of glowstone, yeah, not really worth the effort. But the practical upshot is we have a lot of stuff we can do. So we've got mithril, for example. Let me bring that serpentine down there, put the kimberlite. Did I have some more kimberlite? I did. So we've got all of this kimberlite that needs processing up. And remember, the kimberlite goes into the sag mill, which also uses flint. And I've got plenty of flint because, you know, I ran that. So that was all good as well. So that's all good. Now, this stuff here will smelt down to mana-infused metal, which can be used to make all of these interesting things. I don't know how it compares. So I just have a look at a pickaxe head. So we've got a cobalt we went with, which is a normal pickaxe head. Speed 25, 30, okay. Now, manulin is speed 22, level 8, and 3000. Mithril is actually significantly higher, but slower. Oh, interesting. Okay. What about, so pretty good for those. In terms of sword blades, let's have a look. 170, 120. So still not as sharp, but yeah, it's still there, isn't it? Options, options, options. What about arrow heads? 120 on an arrow head. Let's have a look at arrow heads. I'm just really not sure what the best mithril is. 120 manually is still 170, so with a dunno. I'm not entirely sure whether this is going to be better than anything. Draw speed, arrow speed is there. A bit low on that. Fairy bolts. Okay. Yeah, I'm not entirely sure whether the mithril's really going to be worth anything, but still, let's not be negative about it, eh? Right, so I'm going to just process up these kimberlite. Get the diamond sorted, and then we'll be back in a second. Alright, I have the stink of shame, but that is everything we got out of the nickel, the tin, and the gold. We got a hell of a lot of diamond. Was it worth it? Is it worth sieving all of that for metal? No. No, it's really, really not worth it. Unless it's a particularly hard to come by metal, dairy. Get one of them ones then. Boop, 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 boop. Let me sort myself out and get rid of the stink of shame. This is what happens when I get fixated on something. I lose sight of everything going on around me and just concentrate on the target. And it's not a, it can be a good trait, it's not always a good trait. So now we are less stinky and we can have a drink, we can start to think about what we're going to do next. Now it's interesting, but those diamonds do not appear to be in the recipe for the diamond drill bit, which of course is part of things. So look, got a lot of diamonds. I might as well grab all of this now and transfer it down because we've got the space, I think. So a lot of diamond. Now this stuff can be used to make advanced cards from Applied Energistics, advanced storage housing from Extra Cells 2, a 256k storage, a 1024k storage, it doesn't bear thinking about, a printed engineering circuit, Trunky may become a thing, a reinforced blue gem chest, steel plate and stuff like that, got no idea. Pulsating crystal, that is something I would like to play around with. Painting machine, not so much. Enchanter, diamond chisel, yeah. And then a whole lot of diamond tubes. And a Frankenzombie and a sentient ender. From Immersive. Diamond brick, quite expensive. Firework stars, that's it. Now if we look at the drill bit, it uses Terra Firmacraft diamonds. I don't know how I'm going to get them. Well, I do know how I'm going to get them. I have to go to Gabbro Country, find diamonds and mine it. But I'm not sure whether I'll get diamond or kimberlite from that. This is where it's kind of confusing. So, not sure on where to go with that. Emeralds, but we're pretty good for everything. I do want a diamond. Let's go and have a get a Trunky going, shall we? Because I haven't had a Trunky in ages. For those of you who remember Trunky, Trunky's been in a few episodes, a few seasons of things. And the reason Trunky is a homage to Pateri Pratchett. Who had the luggage, of course. This is where it comes from. and ooh, you're not very healthy. Why are you so damaged? How heal Trunky? Only got 20 life as well. He can take no damage whatsoever. How heal Trunky? Potion of healing. One, two. I'll take three of those. I'm not gonna. After all, I'm not gonna waste. But this is what he does. He follows you, and scares the crap out of you. And he's quite stupid. But in theory, we can turn that into a splash potion and maybe healing. That might work. I'm actually not sure whether I want a Trunky again, but you know, you got to have one because he's there and he's a thing. So I think once I've done finish playing with this particular issue. Hey, come here. Oi. Stay put. No. Okay. Well, we can pick him up. If nothing else, he's a carryable source of inventory. Because we can pop him down, we can jump in, we can take said thing here, pop those away, and you know, pop those in there and pick him up again. Works, I suppose. Anyway, we need to think about what I need to do over here, and what I need to do over here in the first instance is see about expanding this out that way. So I'm going to sleep the night off, grab some wood, and I'll be back in a second. All right, so my plan is, for starters, I'm going to take out this and also down that side, and I need to just go underneath. What did I do down here? Right, so that is a slab there. So we need to slab out to there and then block up there. Okay, that's doable. I need to go and get slabs though, because I didn't bring those. The one thing I didn't bring, well, I didn't bring a lot of things, but you know, the one thing I didn't bring that I probably need. Wooden blocks, should be there. No. Planks, that's hickory, no good to me whatsoever. Great wood. I think I actually need to go and chop down a tree. I'm running a little bit low on great wood, believe it or not, you know. Oh, hello. How are you doing? Not so good. No. Okay, there you go. I'll leave your brain. Wow, zombie had two brains. Cool. Sorry, I'm so easily impressed by these things. Right, so we've got lots of charcoal in there. We've got lots of wood in here. Now, here is the question. Do I bring some more down, or do I just borrow a couple of... I'm going to just borrow a couple of stacks. That will do me, I think, for now. We'll come back for more if I need it. So, with that, we should be good to do that. That should be good to make... some of those, and we can do those and get a bunch of those. That'll work. Excellent. Right, so I suppose I should also just go and get another stack of those, because I am going to need ones to do this as well. All right. So we're going to extend these out. We're going to take both of them. We're basically going to take both of these. We're going to extend them out probably roughly to the end of there. I don't want to get to past the oil. Make these big enough to put the... So we'll keep the cows probably over here. and we'll take the pigoos and the sheeps over there, and we can breed them and do stuff, you know, do all the good things that you do with animals in this game. However, what we do need to do, I think, is start off with a block. Oh, hello. I did not need that there. So we need to bring that down to here. We're going to need a lot more of this wood, actually, but... And we can take you out. And then I think we should be okay just to... I think we'll need to double up. Right, so from there we are going to need to go... Definitely out. No. This is not going to be entertaining. Chopping wood is never entertaining when you're in water, but there you go. Right. We're going to come out from there. And that's going to come all the way across there. And suppose we could just utilize that upside down, couldn't we? I mean, it doesn't make a great deal of sense. You're never going to see it, but it does solve an issue of... Ah! Ow. Swimming is dangerous in this game. Yeah, so take that out. Come back down underneath here, and we should be good then to... Actually, do I want to do that? Or do I just want to build up on the side and run a fence straight down the middle? Oh, God damn it. Okay. This is going to be one of them, isn't it? Okay, I don't even know what I'm doing now. Doesn't matter. We took a bit of damage, but that really doesn't matter. We can take this down here. Pop that back in there, straight down the edge, like a so, and then a fence. We should be all right likewise, so the fence will just basically run all the way down here. Okay, that's fine. In which case, I need to probably, I think, let's head down, straight down. And get that to there. Oh, no. Hang on. And then we'll have a carpenter's block on the top of that. We've got the same here, so that's all good. And then we probably, I think I said we might take this over as a bridge, didn't I? So that means we should, in theory, be okay to take all of this lot out. Okay, let me do some kind of furtling around, working stuff out, and I'll be back in a moment. Okay, there's no avoiding it. I'm going to have to go chop some trees down. Well, I don't have to. I mean, I can continue pillaging the stuff that I put in there, but I'm still going to have to, at some point, chop some of these trees down. So, you know, I've not brought my scythe. That was stupid. I should actually just put my... I've got 30 saplings. Come on, let's just go for it. Go for it. Yeah, I need a lot of this. Wow. That was underwhelming. I mean, 3 stacks of wood. I put all my building stuff in here. Off you go. Good, Trunky. Right, you just sit there. No, don't. Just take those. Thank you. You can't reach them. So, actually, you know what? Oh, he's having a field day. Happy little Trest, isn't he? Let's get some more of these chopped down there, shall we? Now, I have got another mission I want to try and achieve this. Are you full? Oh, you are. Okay. Right, in which case, we'll pick you up and we'll take the get the rest of this old-fashioned way, shall we? How much is do we think there's hiding up there? Good question. I'm going to just get all of these down. I'm going to stack as much as I can into the thing and get them replanted. I might as well while I'm kind of doing homework, so to speak. So yeah, let me just do that. I'll be back in a moment. All right, that's that job done. I really ought to bring some of this crap back with me at some point, you know. However, I'm not, so there you go. I will, however, bring another batch of this lot back. That's full and ready to go. I'm not going to run it today, because if I run it, then I'm just going to have to sit there and I'm going to feel guilty about not digging the charcoal up. And yeah, it's no one needs that guilt. No one needs that going on. However, we do need that lot going on. And where are you, Trunky? Come here. Give me a bunch of that, will you? And let me see what we can get away in there. And then you can have the rest of that back. Immersive engineering, that needs to go away in there. Blah, 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 blah. Right, we are good. We wore out our old steel axe. We're now on a black steel axe, so, you know, it's good, kind of. And I do need to come up with something for these guys as well. Now, these just need to be farmland. I don't even know how hydrated they need to be. So I'm kind of wondering. Now, here is a thought. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, there. So what I'm wondering is this. If I were to come under here, this is not going to be pretty, and do something like, say, that. So I'm just thinking whether I can get away with some kind of window box affair for these guys. Now I do need, where are you, Mr. Trunk? There. I do need some of you. I probably want some more of you, and I almost certainly want some of that. So what if we were to do that plus that and that? Ah, damn it. Fall in. Because it only needs to be a three wide. And there's not a lot of crops left to do either. I mean, there's the vise room we can do. And what else? Vise room. I think the taint. There's a taint one we can do, which we'll probably want. Not for taint, but for the actual essentia. I mean, no, ain't nobody wants taint in their life, obviously. But if we were to come in like a so, and then I should be able to do just that. I think that will do the trick nicely. I'm not worried about that block. I'll live. Right, we need a little bit of dirt. Well, we need quite a lot of dirt, actually, but we need a bit of dirt for this. And the hoe. We're going to need the hoe. Hoe, hoe, hoe. Dirt, dirt, dirt. Yeah, just grab some for now. Hoe? No, you're a nice pick. Hoe, hoe. Hoe, hoe, hoe. Somewhere about there is a hoe. There you go, hoe. Seen better days, but, you know. So have I. Now, if I change the mode on that, the hydration is going to be virtually non-existent. But I don't know if that is going to matter for this. There's only one way to find out again, isn't there? Which is... did I just break my... I did. I'm being a little bit aggressive with my salad eating at the moment. And yeah, I'm going through these bowls like they're going out of fashion. But still, at least I'm fed. Right. Let's put the hoe away. And that will need to move. We'll put you, well, we'll put you there for now. It's as good a place as any. And then we should be good to take that and that. And fertile and can grow. So I think we can get away with that. And we've got a little window box affair going. And that clears up this particular problem. Which is, of course, that I want this to be grass. I also want this to be grass. Of course. You are a carpenter's block, aren't you? How am I going to light this up then? Well, can you put a light onto a carpenter's barrier, I wonder? Well, there is only one way to find out, isn't there? One way to, find out, and that is, if I take a couple of those, a bit of that, that makes a couple. May need to take that out. Now we're seeing that, but if we then go and place, we can. All right, that's interesting. Right, so we can basically, I think, come around here like this. And then use carpenter's barrier all the way around. Yeah, now let me just show you what else we've got going on here. Oh, I need to just re-illuminate that. And we'll do that as well. Now we could change this up to wall or something like that. There are options. But we've got this going over here. That will go around there. Obviously all of this is illuminated as well. These will come out and be made into carpenter's barrier in the same way. And yeah, we'll get a fence gate here, which will allow us to go in through that. And I think the world should be good and happy with that, I believe. We can obviously go and take out 1, 2, 3, 4 of those. I suppose I could just use carpenter's block down there, actually. That might make more sense if I were to take these out. Oops. If I were to take these out and just go with... In fact, actually, let me just have a think about this. So take out this carpenter's block here and that. Let's stick a piece of dirt in here. We should be safe, spawn safe at the moment anyway, because this area is our thing. In fact, I would like to take you out. Thank you. Take that out of there. Do that. Pop that down there. Now, if I were to come and grab that out, leave that one there. 1, 2, 3, how that one, if I were to place that there, glowstone on that side, glowstone on that side. So we just need to work out what we're going to do here, which is going to be simple enough. That will be some glowstone. Yeah, that'll work. And we can do a glowstone here and a glowstone here. So if we, again, if I grab one of those, whack that down. Similarly over there, I think that'll work. Let me repeat that, get that all in. I need to obviously do all of this work around here, get all of this lot out. Not that one, actually, that one needs to stay. But all of the rest need to go, and I'll be back with you in a second. All right, well, that is one side done. Well, apart from, you know, I need to let the grass grow in. But this is all illuminated. We've got a little bridge going over the top. It should be impossible for the animals to escape out of, because obviously they're not wearing boots of the traveler. I mean, they would look awesome if they wore boots of the traveler. Yes, you would, Mr. and Mrs. Cow. You would look brilliant. But we don't want you to wear boots of the traveler. Now, I've gone with a simple wooden bridge over the top so we can get over. I can just drop in, do whatever I need to do, and obviously with these on, I can jump out. I now need to repeat this on this side. Yeah, I'll be back in a little while. So here's the thing I discovered, and it's an interesting thing. Well, it's not that interesting, but it is a thing. So Great wood fences are pretty straightforward. It's a whole bunch of planks and sticks. And of course, the limiting factor here being sticks, because I've always gone, well, I either need to get them by bringing down the leaves on the trees with a scythe or whatever, you know, old TFC styley. Or alternatively, hitting logs with a hammer, and you know, that works too. However, what I discovered is there is another way. Now I'm not entirely sure which mod adds this. By the way, I've decided the animals deserve a little bit of shelter, so I chuck those on as well. I'm not sure which mod adds these, but this particular recipe, we'll find out, shall we? So if you take these and a hammer, you get sticks. I'm not going to do that many. I'm just going to do that many. And wooden twigs can be used to make fire pit ash. So fire pit ash, primitive technology, it must be that then. But you can take your sticks and you can take your knife and you can clean them up and make them all nice and shiny. And I don't know why, but I actually find that quite exciting in a, you know, non-kinky way. Well, yeah, read into that as you will. Because nothing I say is going to change your mind anyway. But yeah, so I've decided we're going to be reasonably kind animal owners, and they are going to have nice little sheltery areas underneath. I mean, they don't have to be, they're not overly shelterized, but things, a little bit of light around the place. Now obviously we don't need this because we have got light blocks in the borders here. But again, whilst I don't, what's the word I'm looking for? I'm not a fan of having to spam torches everywhere. And, you know, there's quite a few Minecraft players who have expressed this opinion, especially vanilla players, because that's their only real option. Spam torches or hide it using very convoluted methods with leaves or carpets or whatever. So the ability to hide lights in, say, carpenter's blocks, really useful. But on the flip side, it is actually quite nice to have the, what's the word I'm looking for here? It's quite nice to have the option to hide them and sometimes make them visible, because, you know, light's just shining from nowhere with no visible source all the time. It kind of suspends disbelief a little bit, I suppose. So here is the question. If I take Mr. Sheepy there. Come on, Mr. Sheepy. Well, Mrs. Sheepy, actually, but come on. Come on. Well done. Come along then. I think the sheeps are somewhat... Come on, you can do it. Oh, come on. There you go. There, look at all that space. You are a lucky sheep. Right, let's go and get your boyfriend. Come on. Come on, Monsieur Le Sheep. We have... I get you. I may get you a lovely field. Lots of space. Come on. Oh, man. Come on. That's right. And then what we'll do is we'll get you all happy-fied on the grass and stuff. And we'll get them all tamed and we'll breed them. And then we'll have baby sheeplets. And these will be good and happy sheep. And that will be great. So the pigs will go in this side. I'm going to bring those across. I'm not entirely sure whether... Come on, piggy. That's right. Pigs will come in the other side. I'm not sure whether they eat the grass anyway. I know the sheep do, because that's, you know... Well, vanilla sheep do that. And there we go. Lovely. Then we'll extend out the cow's pen, and the world will be good and happy. Come on. There we go. Yep. No. Come. Just come on, silly pig. Oh, this one happens just to know where the exit is. Shift. In. Come on, pig. Mind you, pigs are pretty intelligent. You know, growing up on the farm, pigs were very adept at escaping. My granddad always used to say that if someone could come up with a pig-proof pen, they'd make a fortune. Because they were always coming digging under, over, round. You know, they were goddamn escapologists, I tell you. So we've got the sheepies, we've got that in. Let's have a look. I'm going to chop that out. I think what we'll do. Ooh, hang on. Yeah, have I got some dirt? I need a little bit of dirt. So, ooh, hello. Wooden items. Let me get rid of a few bits and pieces while I am here. We need a little bit of dirt, not a lot, just a little bit. One, two, in fact, will do the trick quite nicely. So the only other question then is, do I do I leave them right there? I mean, it really doesn't make sense to leave that in, does it? Except for that. Although that, even that should be okay. No. We can actually... Actually, I should have left that in. Okay, it doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. We'll take that one out. We'll... Oh, hello. Right, so we definitely... Ow. Oh, hello. Got stuck. Right, let me work my way out. We're definitely going to need a bit of slabbage. to... Oh, we did have a slab. Okay. In which case, I'll probably stick that back in, because it's a nice little detail piece. We'll get them slab going down there. That will go in there. And I need more dirt. Let me just quickly pull that together. I'll be back in a second. All right, and on that note, I've got my screenshot. It's got the luggage in it, obviously. This is an old friend there. This is all growing back nicely. These guys are doing their thing. So we've done our expansion of that. I have sorted this lot out. The cows haven't quite figured out that there's all this spare space, but we probably need to do some breedy again. And maybe female, what are you? Both female. Maybe we should be familiarizing these two as well. So that's probably we've got a fair bit of wheat anyway, and I think we should have more. We have got more in there, so so that's a thing. We need to continue working on these, and we need to make plans for my next foray into Thorncraft. But until next time, thank you very much for watching, guys, as ever, and I will see you soon. Bye for now.